All right, guys, coming at you for this second homework assignment. Got a video to help you on solving these equations. I think I got four examples for you. Let's roll. So you got a 17x and a 15x, but they're not together. They're on opposite sides of the equal sign. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this 15. I'm going to move him over so I get my x's together. So 17x, 15x. So you guys have got a feel for how I like to do these problems. If it's a positive on one side, when I move him, if he crosses the equal sign, that changes his value. So that's the only rule to remember. Positive on one side, negative on the other. Same thing on this 3. This 3 was negative. I move it over. If it crosses the equal sign, you change its value. So a negative 3 becomes positive 3. So here we go. We got 17x minus 15x. That's just 2x. Here I've got negative 19 plus 3, negative 16. So whichever way you like to do it is fine. Add in the opposites. If you wanted to add 3 to both sides, that all is going to lead you down the same road. Should get you a 2x, should get you a negative 16. We'll divide by 2 since they multiplied. We divide. X equals negative 8. So we're back in business. We're solving these equations. So there's the first example. Let's do a second example. Got a little trick in this question. All right, so when you go to take down this second problem, there's one trap that's waiting for you pretty much right at the start. We're good with the 10, but this negative 4 has to distribute and hit both those inside there. When it hits both of these, everybody's good on the first one. So everybody's good with 10, 4 times x, 4x, and it's negative. But a lot of people mess up and don't see the second one. Negative times positive. So we know 4 and 2 is 8. But negative times positive becomes negative 8. So this sign right here, be careful. Be on the lookout for that. Okay, so now we're in business. Let's go with like terms together again. So I've got this 6x that was here. I'm going to pick it up and move it. And I'm going to cross the equal sign. So negative 6x becomes positive 6x. But it gives me my x's right together. So we're feeling good about that. The 10's got to go. The 8's got to go. We're going to put them over here on this other side. So when your 10 is positive, when he moves way over here, he becomes negative. The 8 was negative. So when he moves over, he becomes a positive. But nice thing is, letters are together, X's are like terms together. Here's my numbers, they're all together. So however you go about it, whatever moves you make, whatever road you went down, it's all gonna lead you the same way. This becomes a 2X. This is, what is this, 20 minus 10 is 10, 10 plus is 18. And so however you traveled, you end up at the same destination. X equals 9. All right, real quick trick again, make sure you see the negative times positive, change that sign. So instead of positive 8, negative 8. Okay, let's do one with fractions in there. Let's do some fractions. 3. What do I got here? A 5 thirds x equals 30. Okay, so for us, we don't like that 5 thirds. If we could get rid of the 5 over 3, we'd be in business. There's a cool math trick that'll do that. When you have 5 over 3, you can multiply by its reciprocal. So instead of 5 over 3, hit it by 3 over 5. So that reciprocal is going to pull a move and knock it out of our way. All right, it is math class. What you do to one side, multiply by 3 over 5. You must do to the other side, multiply by 3 over 5. It's going to happen on both sides. You're like, yeah, it is. All right, let's go. So this 3 and that 3 cross out, this 5 and that 5 cross out. Right now you're feeling really good. You're like, oh, that was a cool math trick. It all knocked out. You got to clean this up over here on the right side still. A lot of people do this. They'll do the 30 over 1 times the 3 over 5. They like it so they can just multiply the tops, multiply the bottoms. That's kind of the way they like to do it. So what is this? 30 times 3 is 90. 1 times 5 is 5. And we're in business. So to finish this, 90 divided by 5, 18 times. So cool math trick. Get rid of a fraction, hit it by the reciprocal. Let's do one more of these, kind of make sure we've got this, and we'll wrap up this short video. So let's do one of these, maybe throw in a negative sign with us. Negative 4 over 11. X equals, I think I have 24 written there. And I do. Okay, so you walk up to this problem, and you do not like the 4 over 11. You certainly don't like that it's negative. So for us to get rid of it, we're going to hit it by the reciprocal. So instead of 4 over 11, we're going to make it 11 over 4. Let's keep that negative sign in too. Watch this. So I'm going to take the reciprocal with the negative sign, and I'm going to hit it on both sides. So again, negative 11 over 4 on one side means you got to multiply negative 11 over 4 on the other side. But good news. These 11s cancel out. These 4s cancel out. And then watch this. Negative times negative is positive. Like it's all gone. Only thing left is an X. You're like, I do enjoy that, Mr. Porter. All right, so here's 24. Let's put that over 1 times negative 11 over 4. And so we are going to multiply the tops, multiply the bottoms, then just divide it out. So I got to multiply a 24 times 11. What is that? 264. 1 times 4 is 4. And then you get out your calculator. Now you're like, wait, hold on. I can do this with my calculator. I think it's negative 66. And you are all set. Okay, guys. So for this second assignment, you've got fractions. You've got moves to make. You've got like terms to put together. You got to solve these algebra equations.